In the opening scenes, we see a married couple driving in a car. Today Hagen visited a doctor who diagnosed him with hypersomnia. This disorder manifests in overly realistic dreams, possibly triggered by depression. Hagen's wife, Kara, is skeptical about it all. The husband mentioned that the doctor recommended spending a few weeks in a sleep lab, or sleep deprivation could lead to dire consequences. While driving, Hagen doesn't immediately notice a person on the road. Despite taking all prescribed medications, his condition doesn't improve. Hagen felt like he was following his wife through a field but couldn't catch up to her. It turned out Hagen had fallen asleep right at the table. This happens very often, but at night Hagen suffers from insomnia. In the next scene, we see a certain guy entering a cafe at night. At some point, Nico received a call from his accomplice Dan, reminding him that they should meet at the bus stop under the bridge in an hour. Nico looks disoriented, reality and dream are inseparable for him. Hagen abruptly wakes up after a short, restless nap. His dreams are so realistic that Hagen doesn't always understand when he's asleep or awake. In the morning, Hagen has breakfast as usual. Kara is worried that her husband is hardly sleeping. She tried to convince him to stay home today, but Hagen assured her that everything is fine. However, Hagen lied, things are not okay with him. Sometimes he can doze off right behind the wheel of a car and see very realistic dreams. Kara works as a cosmetologist, and Nico is one of her patients. Hagen, on the other hand, works as a security guard in a supermarket. His colleague, Boyko, assumed Hagen has narcolepsy, a sleep disorder. But Hagen objected, he has hypersomnia, not narcolepsy. Suddenly the security guards notice thieves on surveillance cameras. Boyko goes to handle the situation while Hagen stays at the monitors. At some point, Hagen sees Nico at the cashier, the guy from his dreams. Perhaps these were not just dreams. Nico went to the hospital to visit his seriously ill relative. At night, Hagen is once again unable to sleep, sitting in front of the television. When he finally dozes off, Nico comes to his home, where he lives alone. Disorder reigns here. At one point, Nico was back in the ward. Finding himself in the hospital bed, Hagen suddenly woke up. Kara asked what he decided about the sleep lab. Hagen replied that he doesn't want to go there. He is convinced that everything will sort itself out on its own. He falls asleep again, seeing Kara erasing Nico's tattoo. When they kissed, Hagen woke up in a panic. The next time during a nap, Hagen saw surreal images. He doesn't know if on that evening after visiting the doctor, there was a person on the road. Also, Hagen is unsure if there is really an affair between his wife and Nico. From now on, Hagen cannot trust himself. Just like in one of his dreams, Kara's shoe had a broken heel. The next morning, Hagen directly asked his wife if she had been with another man. Hagen confessed that he sees the same guy in his dreams. Kara said that this cannot go on. For the past few months, Hagen has been living in his own world, and the treatment is not helping. He clearly needs to consider the sleep lab. Nico is involved in some criminal activities. At the same time, he's secretly dating Kara. Or is it just Hagen's imagination? Once, Kara confessed that she had actually dated another man. She did it because she felt lonely. Her husband exists somewhere in another reality, and their daughter has long since grown up. Surprisingly, Hagen didn't create a scene, feeling only bitter regret. Nico met with his brother. Their father had passed away, but unlike Nico, his brother does not mourn, believing that their father never cared about them. Tomorrow Nico has to meet with a funeral home worker and take care of everything. During the night Hagen dozed off, seeing Nico drinking in his apartment. At some point, he called Kara and asked her to listen to him. Kara said they had nothing to talk about. Nico shouted that he was her husband as suddenly someone grabbed him from behind. It was Avi and his men, who were unhappy that Nico and his brother tried to deceive them. Hagen was tossing and turning in bed while Nico was being beaten. Suddenly a gunshot rang out. One of Avi's accomplices did it accidentally. As Nico fell, Hagen also fell from the bed. In the morning, Hagen was completely disoriented. Worried, Kara helped him get up. Looking in the mirror, Hagen saw Nico in his reflection. Fortunately, this hallucination didn't last long. In desperation, Hagen smashed the mirror. Their daughter Emily is supposed to visit them today, so Hagen needs to pull himself together. It turns out Nico is not injured. His brother owes something to Avi, and if Avi doesn't get what he wants tomorrow, Nico will have to pay. When Avi and his men left, Nico saw a woman in his house. She is a representative from the funeral home, who is here to discuss all the details of the upcoming funeral. Realizing that she came at an inappropriate time, the woman suggested rescheduling the meeting for tomorrow. Nico started experiencing a strange episode, as if reality around him was changing. Hagen knows he is somehow connected to Nico. Meanwhile, Nico watches as the daughter arrives at Hagen and Kara's home. Nico finds it painful to see Kara with her family. With determination, he knocked on the door. Seeing Nico at the doorstep, Kara tried to chase him away, but Nico was determined to clarify the situation. When Hagen came out, Nico demanded him to answer what he had done. Hagen didn't understand what was being talked about. In the end, Nico was kicked out of the house. For Kara, it was a huge emotional shock. And Hagen finally encountered a person from his dreams in reality. As Nico left, he convinced himself that it was just a dream. He received another call from Dan but ignored it. During dinner with family and relatives, Hagen was not himself. While everyone talked and laughed, he tried to cope with himself. At some point, Hagen couldn't take it anymore and said he needed to leave. Severe insomnia and headaches turned Hagen's life into a waking nightmare. Kara followed him to the bathroom and embraced him. But even the news of his wife's infidelity could not bring Hagen back to reality. Meanwhile, Nico called Kara again, but she ignored the call. Emily senses that something is wrong in the parents' marriage. Kara did not hide from her daughter that she had an affair. She met that guy at work. But it doesn't mean that Kara doesn't love her husband anymore. At night, Hagen suffered from insomnia again. Nico fell asleep right at the table. Next, we see Kara coming to him. Their affair developed rapidly and was very passionate. Perhaps these were memories or just a dream. Nico woke up at the table. In the morning, Hagen did not see his wife next to him. She had woken up earlier and was drinking coffee in the kitchen. The spouses talked to each other as if nothing had happened. This was the first night when Hagen slept relatively well. Nico consulted a doctor with unusual complaints. Lately, Nico feels like he and Hagen are the same person. Dr. Reichert prescribed him a medicine. Soon Kara received a call from Dr. Reichert, her husband's neurologist. The doctor said that a young man had just left his office, claiming to be her husband. Nico went to the pharmacy to buy the medicine. The pharmacist explained that it is a potent drug, and one should not drive after taking it. Hagen tries to find answers, just like Nico. One day, noticing Avi's men, Hagen called Nico and told him to get out of there urgently through the back door. Avi and his men were already on their way. But when they entered Nico's house, he was no longer here. Obviously, someone warned him. By that time, Nico was already at the subway station. The man from the pharmacy recognized him and asked if he had taken the medicine. Nico said that maybe he dreamt it all. However, Nico has no idea that Hagen also sees him in his dreams. While Hagen is getting ready for work, Nico in the metro continues to converse with the same man who told him about the nature of dreams. Everything a person sees in a dream is facets of their subconscious. It turns out that this man is a neuronaut, studying lucid dreaming. He wants to help Nico. While Hagen tries to live a normal life, the new acquaintance explained to Nico that dreams are a kind of parallel world that sometimes intersects with reality. Some may even encounter their alter ego. For each person, there are several ways to check if they are dreaming or not. For example, one can cut off their access to oxygen. If a person continues to breathe, it means they are asleep. Nico said it's different for him. Suddenly, the man screamed loudly, making Nico nervous. The doctor explained that he did it to jolt him. Every time Nico started to fall asleep and see his strange dreams, the doctor would start screaming. Later, Nico received another call from Dan, and this time he answered. Dan reminded him that they were supposed to meet at the bus stop under the bridge in an hour. Nico vaguely remembers hearing this before. For Nico, the two realities have again blended, as well as the past with the future. It seems like a long nightmare that never ends. In the end, Nico woke up on the couch in the doctor's house. It turns out that Nico was in a state of sleep paralysis but forgot to perform the reality test as the doctor advised. Nico said he needs to go to his wife. Before Nico left, the doctor warned him that sleep and wakefulness phases may change unnoticed for him. But now Nico is prepared. During dinner, Hagen suggested to his wife and daughter to go somewhere over the weekend, like Paris. Emily is very worried about her father, who has been behaving very strangely lately. The phone calls from an unknown caller to her mother bother Emily just as much. Upon the advice of the doctor, Nico conducts a reality test. It seems he is not asleep. Or it seemed at first glance. At some point, Nico saw the cafe from his dream in front of him and walked inside. It was like a closed loop. Nico just now remembered that his father had passed away. The waitress, his ex-girlfriend, yelled at him after her shift. They have a common child, but in 2 years Nico has not sent a single card to their daughter. The girl yelled at Nico for a long time, saying that he is incapable of taking responsibility. Then the girl more calmly said that if he wants to change something, he must go back to the beginning. After a few minutes, Nico saw Dan in front of him. Somehow they ended up at the bus stop under the bridge. Dan was very angry. In the next moment, Nico woke up in the same place, but Dan was no longer here. He remembers that he needs to go back to the beginning. Kara asked her husband if he would go to the doctor tomorrow. Hagen feels better, but he thinks it's a good idea to see a doctor. What's happening to him also affects his family. Nico went to sleep in his apartment, intending to go back to the beginning. However, instead of himself, he saw Hagen, who is involved in some illegal dealings with Avi. Hagen handed him the stolen merchandise. Later, not finding Hagen at his workplace, they came to his house. Kara opened the door, not understanding what was happening. These people began to threaten Kara and Emily, demanding to know where Hagen is. In tears, Kara said that her husband left in the morning. Kara was sure he was at work. Avi was losing patience. In the next moment, Nico was awakened by his brother, who wanted to know where the merchandise was. Nico confessed that Hagen stole it, and he is working with his partner Boyko. Perhaps Hagen learned about the merchandise from his wife because Kara was in the know. Nico unquestioningly trusted her, but apparently in vain. Hagen is constantly late and has become very inattentive at work, which did not go unnoticed by Boyko. Suddenly, he noticed on surveillance cameras an elderly lady attempting to steal something. While Boyko called the police, the elderly woman humiliated the security guards, claiming she was a former opera singer and they were nobodies. The brother called Nico a coward. He always has been one and still is. The brother also hinted that he is somehow involved in their father's demise. Noticing Hagen, the brothers put on masks, followed him and blocked his path, demanding to know where the merchandise was. Hagen said he returned it. Despite the threats, Hagen continued to move forward. This prompted his brother to shoot and run away. But Nico continued to stand and took off his mask. Kara and Emily talked as if nothing happened. Perhaps nothing really did. Suddenly, there was a knock on the door. Knowing that Kara was in danger, Nico rushed to her. Avi and his men were already there. Everything is repeating. The boundaries of reality are blurred. Hagen doesn't understand who he is, just like Nico. Fortunately, the guy made it in time, and entering Kara's house, took the lives of Avi's men and Avi himself. He did it for his beloved. Nico and Kara stared at each other for a long time. Realizing they were safe, the mother and daughter embraced. Before leaving, Nico said he loves them both. Meanwhile, Hagen is driving and crying. The police arrive at the house. Officers shouted at Nico to drop the weapon, but at that moment he only wanted one thing, to go back to the beginning. To do that, he must end this life. In the last seconds, memories or maybe dreams flashed through Nico's mind. Hagen stopped the car and fell asleep. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel not to miss more exciting new products. Also, the authors will be pleased if you leave your opinion in the comments.